Now to the verdict for the two officers charged in the 2019 death of Elijah McClain, whose death in police custody sparked nationwide outrage. A jury convicting one officer, but acquitting the other. Our Chief Justice Correspondent Pierre Thomas is in Washington this morning with more. Good morning, Pierre.
Juju, good morning. Today, despite that conviction, Elijah McClain's family is still demanding justice in this troubling case. No crime had been committed, and McClain was not armed, dying because of what appears to be a tragic misunderstanding. Warning, what you're about to see is not graphic, but it is emotionally wrenching.
This morning, a Colorado police officer guilty of illegally killing Elijah McClain, a young man whose death shocked the nation.
We, the jury, find the defendant, Randy Roedema, guilty of criminally negligent homicide.
McClain's mother raising her fist as she left the courthouse, telling reporters she's not satisfied.
This is the divided states of America, and that's what happens.
McClain's mom clearly frustrated that Roedema faces less than a decade in prison and that another officer was acquitted in the killing of her son, who by all accounts was a gentle person who loved to play the violin, and whose death raised serious questions about race and policing. The end of McClain's life all caught on chilling police body camera footage. His death, a tragic misunderstanding. It was August 2019, and McClain, a massage therapist, was walking home after buying iced tea from this convenience store.
Stop right there. Hey, stop right there.
Police confronting McClain after receiving a report of a suspicious person wearing a ski mask. McClain's family says he wore that ski mask because he was anemic and often felt cold. Police grabbed McClain within 7 seconds of the encounter.
Stop. I have a right to stop you because you're being suspicious.
The officers apply a chokehold. McClain tries reasoning with them.
I'm so sorry. I have no gun. I don't do that stuff. I don't do any fighting. Why would you touch me?
He's in pain.
I can't breathe correctly because...
And with that, Elijah McClain's life was soon over, inspiring violin vigils throughout the country, even though his music was silenced forever.
During the confrontation with police, McClain was injected with a powerful sedative. The 23-year-old suffered a heart attack. 3 days later, he was brain dead. Guys...
Pierre, thank you so much.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.